being a marketing consultant doesn't pay. Do this technique instead. Hey, have you been a marketing consultant or are you working on your own business? I know marketing consultants are pretty much a dime a dozen now. It used to be years ago when you would tell somebody about an autoresponder or how to set up emails or a sales page, they were blown away. They thought, oh my God, that's really cool. I'll pay you a ton of money to do that for me. But guess what? They aren't doing it anymore. They're not paying people for this. They're getting somebody in-house to do this and they no longer need you. So I'm going to show you in this video, if you're a consultant, how to make more money by doing a few techniques that nobody else is doing, and if it's for your own business, how you can apply them to increase your sales. And we're starting right now. Hey, I'm J.R. Fisher. I've been selling online since 2009 and I've sold millions of dollars of both digital and physical products, and I've learned a lot over these years, and on this channel I share all of those things with you so that you can get good results too. Also, at the end of this video, I've got a free e-commerce course that you can get absolutely free, and I'll show you how to do that. Now, have you been a marketing consultant? Are you working in your own business and doing the online marketing and you've run into some difficulties? In this video, I'm going to show you exactly what you need to concentrate on to get your marketing consultant business back again, or just apply them to your own business to get incredible results. So let's get going and let's take a look at what you need to do. So let's go through some of the steps that you're going to really need to concentrate on that really will differentiate your business or your marketing company from everybody else. Number one is customer experience. Now, 2020 is gonna be the year of the customer experience. It's no longer about selling your product and features and benefits. Now, I'm not saying you don't have to say those things anymore. You do. This is stuff in addition to what you had to do before, and that's kind of how competition works, where you had to do everything you had to do in the past and you have to do more. But this year and from this point forward, I know customer experience is gonna be paramount. Customer experience and how they interact with your business and how you treat people will be major. And if you're a marketing consultant and you're working with businesses, this is something you need to get set up for that business so that they can gain more business. When polled, 73% of consumers said that the customer experience was really one of the most important things that would affect their buying decision. But when we checked with companies and they were polled, they said only 49% of most companies had this customer experience thing set up properly. Now, what exactly is a great customer experience? Well, efficiency is one, convenience is one, knowledgeable about your product or service is something else. All of these things are going to come into customer experience, and those are the things that are going to differentiate businesses from other businesses by having this pre-set up into their system. Now, as you can see from this diagram on the screen right now, there's all kinds of different areas where customer experience comes into play. You need to consider customer experience in every aspect of your marketing strategy. This is how you're going to really provide a good customer experience in order to keep your customers and, more importantly, attract new ones. In fact, as you go through the list, you're going to see that every trend is really just one factor of the overall customer experience. Number two is employee engagement. This is so very important at this point. If efficient and friendly service is given to your customers by your employees, you're going to be leaps and bounds ahead of everybody else. In one of the latest surveys, customers said that if they didn't have a knowledgeable employee at a business, that 46% of them would just leave the brand altogether. They expect your employees to be knowledgeable. So education for your employees, treating your employees right, making sure they're happy, that's super important. I know when I go into some fast food joints, they act like I shouldn't even be there, and I shouldn't be at fast food at all. But I will tell you, some of the experiences when I do go vary a lot according to brand. I mean, you go into a Chick-fil-A and these people are happy that you're there. It's always, no matter what you ask, it's my pleasure, my pleasure, my pleasure. They're super happy about helping you. Same thing with In-N-Out Burgers. They're just super happy. They want to help you out. They want to do a good job. A lot of the other franchises, you can't say that about them. Now, keep in mind, all of these franchises are pulling from the same pool of people. And generally, people want to be happy on their jobs. They want to feel good about their jobs. They want to be knowledgeable about their jobs. So what it really comes back to is the management. How are they training these people? How are they treating these people? And it's not always just about money, because if that was the case, the people that paid the most amount of money would have the most perfect people. But it's not that. Now, some of these places, In-N-Out or maybe Chick-fil-A, may pay a little bit more than the other ones, but it's not that. It's the experience that the employee has at work, how they're treated, how they're trained. Do they feel knowledgeable? Do they feel like they're putting out a good product? And if they have all these things going for them, they're going to be pretty happy employees, which leads to happy customers, which leads you to more business. Now, let's check out this chart real quick here. And the chart is about what drives people away from your business. So let's take a look at it. The number one thing that drives people away from business is bad employee attitudes, unfriendly service, untrusted company, unknowledgeable employees, and inefficiency. Those are the big ones. On the other end, you know, if you have a celebrity that's promoting your business, or if it's not global or something like that, that's part of it, but it's such a small part of it. It's really those big four there, as you see on the bottom: the bad employee attitudes, the unfriendly service, the untrusted company, and the unknowledgeable employees. And of course, inefficiency comes into play there too. So that's really what we're shooting for when we're trying to help your business, or if you're a marketing consultant trying to help other people. Remember, your employees are the face of your business, and if you don't spend time with them, if you don't help them, if you don't support them, if you don't work for them, you know, people say, well, my employees work for me. No, you really work for them. I mean, that's how it really works in today's world. It's not like that anymore, where you can just put people out there without training them, without giving them the tools they need, and expect your business to do well. Understand, most businesses will pay the person who has the most influence over a customer the least amount of money and give them the least training. And you see this all the time in reception desks, whether it's car dealerships or hotels or whatever. That person that's paid the least is right out front with the customer, and they have fewer tools and less support than any other position in the company. That's crazy. Number three, visualization. Now, we've all been told that with the advent of this voice search, that people don't care to see anything anymore, and nothing could be further from the truth. People still love visuals, okay? They still want to see images, they still want to see videos, they still want to see these pictures out there. So that's an important component that you're going to need to add to your marketing strategies. In fact, research has shown that people much prefer visual content over plain text or even audio. You don't have to look far to actually find examples of this. I mean, Pinterest exists and Instagram exists, and they are growing, and they're growing because of images. Now, as you can see by this visual right here, 65% of us are visual learners, and I know I fall into that category. It says 80% colored visuals increase people's desire to read content by 80%. So even if you do have written content, having that color there is really important. People are 85% more likely to buy your products after watching a video about it. So we cannot neglect videos. I mean, hey, you're watching this video right now to learn how to do this stuff. Also, 93% of all communication is visual. Okay, it's not audio. So hey, Google, and you know, hey, Alexa, and all that stuff, that's a supplement, but that will never take the place of visuals. This is why visuals attract our attention and affect our attitude. 180% posts with images produce 180% more engagement. That's insane. And our brain processes visuals 60,000 times faster than text. So these visuals are super, super important. And that's why Pinterest, Google, and all these other companies are also investing in visual search technology. Images are already returned for 19% of all searches on Google. Okay, check this out. Here is a graph put out by eMarketer. And if you notice at the top, it says ability to search by image. Okay, this is what they're looking for. This is split into younger millennials, which are 18 to 20 year olds, and then older millennials, which are 21 to 34 year olds. And I think what is startling right here is there's not much difference in how they think, but it's 62.2% and 61.7%. And then as you drop down a little bit, shoppable content, click to purchase, images, videos, articles, that type of thing. thing, 57% and 58.5%. And then you go into augmented reality. Looks like try before you buy, and that's when the groups start to separate a little bit. But you see 36.8% for the younger millennials, and then the older millennials, which is 21 to 34, is 28.6%. And then it even really drops down to live chat and messaging. And that's not even half of what visual search is. So they don't want to talk to anybody. They want to see images. And here's the interesting thing, really. Visuals are also a whole lot easier to remember because we think in pictures. So they're easier to remember than text. It's hard to remember text, but you can remember a picture in your mind. Number four is personalization. You know, everybody is flooded with ads anymore. And as you see all these ads, you know, you become blind to them because there's so many ads hitting you. They say the average person sees about 10,000 ads a day. So what can you do? Number four is personalization. What you can do is personalize your message to these people. Now, with all this data we're collecting about them, about what they like and where they go and what they want to do and what they're interested in, we can actually interject that into our messages. We can also put their names in emails. We can talk about previous purchases they made. We have access to this information, and by doing that, by making these messages more personal, it actually increases the conversion rate. Now, you know, you think it's hokey when you say Dear John or Dear Becky or whatever in your email, but when consumers were polled, they said that they would be 80% more likely to buy from a brand that personalized the message. Now, in 2002, there was a movie called Minority Report. Tom Cruise played a guy named John Anderton, and as he walked through the city, he would be bombarded by ads that were personalized, and they would be saying, "Hey John, Mr. Anderton," and all these constant messages that were personalized, and it sounded insane. And yet 20 years later, that's exactly what's going on, and it actually works. Now, marketing personalization is not just focused on the person's name. Hey, we get that. But you've got tons of information about these people. You know what pages they went to. You may know what videos they've watched. You know what products they bought. So you can actually do product recommendations based on all these activities and really have a more focused marketing campaign for your customers. Number five is strategic marketing transformations. So once you've started marketing to your customers, you're going to want to transform into other areas. Now, collecting all this data from your customers, their purchase history, what they're interested in, what they've done in the past, this will help you transform or transition into your new marketing strategy and what you may be selling them. It may be another product, it may be another avenue, maybe a different kind of funnel, but by combining all this information, you may find that somebody who, like say, purchases our survival food, something along those lines, is actually interested in camping products too, which is not the initial marketing campaign, but it's related enough to where they're probably going to buy those products too. Number six is SERP, S-E-R-P, position zero and featured snippets. Now, SEO was forgotten for a lot of years because people figured out ads and social media and all that, and they missed out on a lot of opportunity. But this SEO is gonna continue to be super important in the years to come, and probably even more so now that there's so many people in the advertising area. In fact, here's the truth. If you SEO your pages properly, you stand a whole lot better chance of really getting to the customer now, because you know your ways of searching now are entirely different. I know I can sit in my living room and just speak to Google and say, "Hey, I want particular information," and rather than having to go to a page and click on it and open it up and read that information, Google will bring back the most relevant information. So if you have SEO'd your pages correctly with the right title tags and descriptions that are matching even voice searches, Google will actually read your information out to that person. Or if you're on a computer, your mobile, laptop, whatever, it can be one of the top results, but they can actually read it within the Google results without ever having to go to your page. Now, if you have a result like that, and I've done this myself, where it's the result that Google has on the page and I can actually read it, I'll often go to that page to get the rest of the information, because they usually just perform a snippet. And that's what I said in the beginning of this, snippets. Snippets are so important. That way I can get the main idea, but if I want more information, I click and go to it. And I would say more than 50% of the time, I'll actually click that link and go and get the rest of the information. Now, these results that actually appear in the Google results, these snippets, okay, it is said that when somebody does a search, about 60% of the time now, these snippets or these short versions of your answer will appear within the Google search results. So they are really, really important at this point. Now, brands are obviously trying to figure out how to get into that position. So you're going to see more and more digital marketers, internet marketers, SEO companies advertising that they can get you into that snippet area so that your business comes up first. It's called Area Zero, basically. It's not first page results, it's zero page results, because you don't have to go anywhere. Number seven is voice search. Now, I know I've already mentioned voice search a couple times before, but it's worth really looking at a little bit closer. It's been said that in 2020, which is this year, that probably about 50% of the searches online are gonna be voice searches. So you need to be prepared for that. Consumers are actually planning on using voice search more. The more they get accustomed to it, the more they get good results, the more they're going to use it. It's been said that 61% of the people that are 25 to 64 plan on using voice search more in the future than they have in the past. Now, some companies have really picked up on this. The tequila maker Patron actually has a recipe section. So when you are searching, voice searching, you can say Patron recipe for margarita, Patron recipe for Mai Tai, Patron recipe for, and they have an entire section that will bring back information about recipes using Patron, which actually sells their product. So you may want to think about how you can incorporate that into your business or into your client's business. Number eight is AI-based automation. Oh my gosh, we're seeing more and more of that. Now, I don't think you're gonna see the Terminator robot walking around, but you are finding that AI is becoming a bigger and bigger player in search and getting businesses more customers. AI is also behind all those little chat bots you see all the time, where you can converse back and forth with your customers, and that AI knows what they're saying and it knows what sequence of messages to send them down based on their previous answer. Now, I understand people are always going to be important. You're never going to be able to replace people with some bot or some AI. But what you could do is you could use this AI or this bot technology to get them to the right person, okay? To the right product, to the right information that they want. And once you get them there, of course, a human could take over from that point forward. Number nine, focus on customer retention. This is so very important, because if you've already got a customer, you want to keep that customer. It costs a lot of money to get a customer. I woke up today and I had an email in my email feed, and it was from Starbucks. And Starbucks said to me that they would give me 25 extra points if I made any purchase over the next 4 consecutive days, or they would give me 50 points if I made any purchase over the next 6 consecutive days. So as you can see, what they're doing there is they're rewarding me for coming back over and over again, because they know I'm already a customer. Now, it's always been known that recurring purchasers are more valuable to a business than a new customer. I mean, that's obvious, right? Because they keep buying. But what's really interesting is loyal customers help build that business's brand. So if you can build in that loyalty through some method with your business, whether it's coupons or discounts or special things or VIP treatment, that's going to build that customer loyalty, which will help build your brand. And number 10, the big one, live video. Oh my gosh, live video is so very important. Now, this is a recording you're seeing here now, but you know, we've started doing lives more on Facebook. I'm going to be doing more lives on YouTube, because people like to jump in there and they like to be able to converse and, you know, ask you questions and go back and forth. So live is actually going to be huge. They say it's going to be a $70 billion industry by 2021. Now, it's been proven that people will spend 3 times as much time watching a live video as a recorded video. So if you want to get your watch time up, you know, and you're on YouTube, or your businesses that you work for are on YouTube, I would suggest you doing live. I know we're going to do more of it. Now, as you can see in this visual here, this is how people actually prefer to learn about a new product or service here. And other is a very small portion, and so is presentation pitch, which you probably spend a lot of time on. Sales calls is very small. If you look in here, ebooks or manuals, very small. Then it changes up a lot. It says test-based article, website, post, that's 15%. But check this out, short videos account for 68% of how they wanna learn about your product. So if you don't have short videos about your product, you're really missing the boat. Now, when you add into those videos a live component, you've really, really grown that loyalty of that customer and the odds that they're gonna purchase the product from you. And of course, three times the chance of them watching more of that video. Now, what is it about live videos that makes people keep watching? It's called FOMO. That's right, FOMO. It's fear of missing out. In a live video, they don't know what's gonna be said next. They know they can't go back and watch it necessarily. So the chances of them jumping out of that video are a whole lot less than on a recorded video. Okay, so what do? You get started now, because putting these things off is just gonna cost you. The information's out there. Other people know this information at this point, and if they're competitors of yours, the odds are they're gonna probably pick up on it. Now, maybe you have weak competitors and you know you can really jump ahead of them by applying some of this stuff, but the point is you wanna get on it as soon as possible. If you utilize these 10 steps, you will increase your business, you will improve your brand, your loyalty, and your profits, and that's what we all wanna do. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video. I want to know, what did you get out of this video? What one of these things do you think you can apply in your business, or have you applied in your business? Please put that in the comments below. Now, if you have questions about this video, also put those questions down there. I'll be happy to respond to them. Don't forget, there's a free e-commerce course at the end of this video. All you gotta do is go down into the description. There's a link down there. You click and learn. No credit card required, nothing. Just click and learn. Now, also, don't forget to subscribe and what? Ring the bell, ring that notification bell over there. Turn on all notifications. That way you become part of the Fisher family. The VIP group, that's right, VIP people who are notified in advance of everybody else. I can actually send you an email every time I do a new video so you don't miss out on a single one. I really appreciate you watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Hey, thanks for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click that little bell right there so you can be notified every time I do a new video. Also, click on one of those videos there. Keep watching on my channel.